So this topic that is crystal oscillator is presently used in both the directions, in medical diagnostic technique as well as the scientific diagnostic, as instrument to find out the structure of the material, the composition of the material in the research field. And that's why it is very important. So a crystal oscillator is an electronic circuit that uses the mechanical resonance of vibrating crystal of piezoelectric material to create electrical signal with a very precise frequency. Precise frequency means you can easily detect the boundary of the two materials, two interfaces, so that you can determine the crystal structure. And the materials used, as I have said, quartz crystal, this is basically an isotropic, material. This is an isotropic material. And the phenomena is piezoelectric effect. It was invented in 1880 with the Pierre Curie and Jacquin, which was used in large scale in World War First in the water navigation technique, that is sonar. And then it was prepared the crystal quartz oscillator, quartz clock during 1920 to 30 with the high precision, that is 30 millisecond in 1 year. And it is also used in the educational academic part, that is ultrasonic. We have the one experiment in our class as well. So the theory behind this one is the piezo, it is the Greek word. This is the Greek word piezo, and this piezo was this. Piezo was a Greek word pressure, and due to the pressure, there is a electricity. So it is known as piezo. Due to the piezo pressure, there is a creation of electricity. So it is called piezoelectric effect. The inverse is also possible, that is by application of electricity, electric field. There is a pressure creation on the material and it is vibration. So it is known as inverse piezoelectric effect. So due to the mechanical vibration, the longitudinal wave produced with a very high frequency, that is above 20 kilohertz, and that's why it is called as ultrasonic. We have mechanical wave in three classification. Mechanical wave as the classification is infrasonic, then sonic, and then ultrasonic. Then ultrasonic, the frequency is less than 20. Here it is 20 to 20 kilohertz. And there is more than 20 kilohertz. So it is termed as, this frequency is more than 20 kilohertz, then it is termed as the ultrasonic. So let us see the crystal structure. The crystal structure of the crystal structure is very important. You can draw this crystal as you can draw this kind of the structure of the crystal, and then so this crystal is cut in various cross sections. These cross section, if you draw this one is axis. So it is Z, this is Z dash axis. So there are three axes if you design this one is. This is X axis, Y axis and Z axis. So this X axis is dash is known as electrical axis. This Y dash is mechanical axis, and this Z dash is termed as optical axis. That is, you have read optic axis. So this is your optic axis. Optic axis. Now, if we consider the structure, something like this structure, and you see the crystal structure of quartz is SiO2. So suppose this one is the three corner of the molecule atom, silica, and these three are oxygen. So this is symbol of the silicon atoms, and here it is oxygen atoms, silica. We know that electronegativity of oxygen is greater than electronegativity of silica. So the bond, the first point, bond is polar. Bond is polar. And due to this, there is positive and negative poles form And this oxygen has relatively negative charge. This has relative negative charge in comparison to the silica. Means these two pair electrons are shifted towards the oxygen. These two electrons are shifted towards the oxygen. These are shifted towards the oxygen. These are shifted towards the oxygen. These are shifted towards the oxygen. And that's why oxygen we have like a negative charge center. While if the electrons are shifted towards the oxygen and oxygen get negatively charged, then this silica will get a positively charged. Then silica get the positively charged, and this positive charge is delta plus. This positive charge is delta plus. This kind of the phenomena is here. So this is the crystal from normal state. Now, what will happen if we apply the pressure? If you apply the pressure, then what? The structure is slightly flattened. The structure is slightly flattened in this way. What is going to be happen in this case? You see, this one is the, say it is a surface. Here it is another surface plate. And applying the pressure, this is the pressure that we apply. This is the pressure applied. So due to this pressure, this silica is bending inside. This silica is bending inside. And here the oxygen is bending inside. And with this result, these two oxygens which are connected with silica is coming up. And these two silica are coming up outside. So what will happen? Hello. Good morning. चल रही है अभी. बस एक घंटा बाद. एक घंटा बाद. So these two silica are positively charged and these are negatively charged. So this negative charge separation are closer, and therefore this surface will get slightly negative charge, and here it is the positive charge coming closer to the surface. So this surface will get positive charge in this way. So, and R, if we pull these one, if we pull the structure, this is pull, this is the pull structure, then what will happen? These are coming out, this silica is coming out. Here this oxygen is coming out, and these two oxygens are remaining intact. So if this oxygen is coming out, which is negatively charged, so this surface will get negative charge. And here, since delta positive is a silicon, Si, these are Si, these are Si, which is positive, which is delta positive, and this is the negative. So this part is, the surface is positive charge. The surface is positive charge. So either pushing or pulling. This is your pushing, and here it is pulling. So due to pushing, the upper surface get negatively charged. This one is a negatively charged, and here it is positively charged. While pulling, this will get positively charged, and this will get negatively charged. So either pulling or pushing, there is a change of polarity. There is change in polarity on the crystal surface, which is perpendicular to operation. I mean to say, if the electric axis, the mechanical axis, that is mechanical pressure is applied along y axis, then electrical charge is produced on x axis. So these mechanisms can also be explained with this factor. So the mechanism is, suppose this is a crystal. Suppose this is a crystal, and by the application, cubic crystal, by the application, if this dimension will change, this dimension will decrease, so this dimension will increase. So how this can be happen? This will increase something like this. This will happen. You know? This will decrease and this part will increase. Or the other case will, this section will increase. So this section will increase something like this. Something like this. So this is the mechanical vibration. It is the mechanical vibration. Mechanical vibration, the change of dimension. Mechanical vibration, that is change in dimensions, change in dimensions. So these properties are utilized to produce the electric field. For example, suppose electric field is applied along the x-axis. Along the x-axis means, you see this one is the x-axis, and electric field apply in this way. Electric field is applied in this way. So what will happen, if we draw this diagram, something like this. Draw the diagram, something like this. So if we apply the electric field, so this is the positive end, and this will be the negative end. This will be the negative end. So on this surface, which is the positive plate, and this surface, which is the negative plate, this surface is the negative plate, then there is a vibration along the y-axis. If it is y-axis, so mechanical vibration, you see, the length is, this length is, you can say, expansion here, it is contraction, and here it is expansion. So if this one is the case, and in this case, due to this case, the contraction is something like this. The contraction is something like this. That is, something like this. That is contraction. Then this one is case one. And case two, when we change the direction of field, that is, this is the original. This is the original. And here, and the direction of electric field is something like this. That is, at this end, it is the positive plate. And here it is the negative plate. This end is the negative plate. So what will happen? If we change this direction of electric field, then this kind of expansion is there. This kind of expansion is there. This is expansion. This kind of expansion is there. So what is going to be happen in these diagrams by the application of electric field? By the application of electric field, there are change in the dimension. And if this one is simply represented as this is x-axis. So the field can be represented in this direction. That is, electrical axis, x dash, x double dash, whatever it may be. And the change is here, mechanical. Mechanical axis. This is the mechanical axis. So the overall is yy dash increases, expansion means yy dash increases, and here construction means yy dash decreases. This is the increases and this is the decreases. So if this crystal mechanism, used the crystal vibration mechanism is used to produce the wave, by the application of alternating voltage. Hello. Alternative voltage. So this can be, this can be shown as, suppose this is the plate, and this place is connected to the alternative source. So what will happen? There is change of alternative voltage. This is positive and this is negative. And here it is negative and then positive. For one cycle, this is for one cycle, it is the another cycle. One, another. One cycle and another cycle. So if for one cycle it is positive, then this part is negative. This is the first cycle. For the second cycle, when it is positive, this will be negative. And then this will be negative. So what will happen? If you have the crystal, in this way, then this direction will vibrate. Means this, if you draw the two-dimensional diagram, so we can say that this kind of the change of the thickness, or this can be something like this. This mechanical. This is the mechanical. So what will happen? And if this one is submerged, into the liquid, if the whole apparatus is submerged into the liquid, then the whatever the liquid present, this is submerged liquid around the crystal, then the expansion, and this one is the rarefaction, is produced. That is, this is mechanical wave. Now the mechanical wave, the velocity of mechanical wave is V, which is under root of Young's modulus. Young's modulus by density. Young's modulus by density, that is under root y by rho, Young modulus by density. And this wavelength, that is the thickness. So if thickness of quartz crystal is T, then the wave is like, this is T, thickness is lambda by 2. Thickness is lambda by 2. Or this lambda is equal to 2t. The lambda is equal to 2t. So if you interested to find the frequency, then this frequency f, so we know that V is equal to N frequency, or this is N into lambda. So N is equal to V by lambda. N is equal to V by lambda. And then this V by lambda, then this frequency is N. So N is equal to V by lambda, that is lambda is 2t, and this velocity is Young modulus upon density. One modulus upon density. So this is Y by D. If we consider the numerical values of the materials like Young's modulus, Young's modulus y is equal to say 8.55 Newton per meter square, and density is rho is equal to, this density is 2.65 into 10 to the power 3 kg per meter cube, and this thickness is T, that is 5 mm, that is 5 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter, 5 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter. So the frequency in this condition is n is equal to 1 upon 2 into 5 into 10 to the power minus 3, and this is 8.55 into 10 to the power 10. Yeah, this has to be multiplied 10 to the power 10, Young's modulus, Newton per meter square upon 2.65 into 10 to the power 3 kg per meter cube. And after solving, we'll get this is 575 kilohertz. This is n. So this kind of frequency, will be there in the mechanical vibration. Now the same diagram, the crystal can be considered as the resonance circuit as LCR resonance circuit. That is, suppose this one is the plate and here it is the crystal. Here it is again plate. So these are the plates and this is the crystal. So this arrangement, the whole arrangement can be considered as LCR circuit. LCR circuit is something that LC and R. This is the LCR circuit. And for typical value, L is said to the 137 Henry. C is equal to 0.035 picofarad, that is 0.0235 into 10 to the power minus 12 farad. And this resistance is 15 kilo ohm. So at the time of resonance, then the frequency can be written as N is equal to 1 upon 2 pi under root 1 upon LC at resonance condition, and N is equal to 1 upon 2 pi under root C plus Cm. This is LC into CM at the normal condition. So this one is case. If we like to have example, calculate the frequency, of the circuit at resonance having L is 1 Henry, C is 0.01 pf, then N is equal to 1/2 pi under root 1/LC. So this is 1/2 × 3.14 under root 1/1 × 0.01 × 10⁻². So after solving, you'll get this one is 1.589 megahertz. So in this way, we can have the frequency of the crystal oscillator by assuming this different way, and these crystal can be used to produce the circuit, and there are two type of the circuit. The electronic circuit is of two types, namely first is series feedback, and second is parallel feedback. Now, series feedback, we can draw the circuit as, this is a transistor, this is NPN transistor, this is capacitor, emitter and base terminal of a transistor, and here it is self-bias configuration. This is RFC with V++ source, and for the DC operation, we are using these two resistances. This is R1 and this is R2. Here it is ground. So these are the normal circuit configuration, and crystal is used as this one is the crystal oscillator. This is the crystal oscillator, which is called as control. There is a C, capacitor. So this is the series feedback. Directly the output is fed to the input. This is a VBE. Base emitter voltage should be greater than 0.7 in case of silica. And this one is R1 and R2. These two things are here. R1, R2 used for potential divider regarding DC bias. this is as, this is Re and Ce. This Re, Ce, self bias, Re, Ce, self bias, and control for the series, series feedback, series feedback path, series feedback path. And then whatever the frequency generated at this C collector end output, part of them is feedback through the crystal, and then there is a sustained oscillation. Now, in case of parallel feedback, we consider this one is a transistor. This is a transistor. And this transistor is connected to the this self bias, and here it is coil RFC, and this two resistances R1 and R2. This R1 and R2 for the DC stabilizer. Now the crystal is, here is the control. Crystal is connected to the parallel of the circuit. And it is being fed at the base terminal in this part. And this one is the V0 output. This is your V0 output. So this is the C1, and here it is C2. And this is the control crystal. So C1 and C2 along with the control, this provide the parallel feedback path, So in this way, this is the grounded as well. Here it is, well, in this way, the crystal oscillator is used for the both cases, series feedback circuit and parallel feedback circuit, and the applications are there. Now, the last point that we have to discuss about this one is the experimental part. Experimental part of the ultrasonic. So what is the basic feature? The basic feature is, suppose this one is a container. Suppose this is the container. And in this container, there is a liquid, something, sometime kerosene oil. Or any kind of the oil that is used. And here it is, the oscillator. here it is the oscillator to the source, and this is the crystal. So what is going to be happen in this way? When it is submerged, then we can have the simplified diagram. The simplified diagram is something like formation of, this is the compressed part. This is the compressed part. So this is compressed part, and this is the rarefaction part. So this is something like behave as a caustic grating. This is acoustic grating. And in this acoustic grating, if light is incident, suppose this is the light, light incident, and here the experimental setup. So when light is incident on this and there is a caustic grating, so there is a this kind of phenomena is taking place. And this phenomena is diffraction grating. This phenomena is diffraction grating. So by the help of, here it is the collimator. This is the spectrometer. Spectrometer setting. This is the incident source of light. Incident source of light. And this is grating. And here it is telescope. Whatever you are observing. So there are three parts. Now this diffraction is being observed with this using the two formula. This is 2d sine theta is equal to n lambda. And the second one is the frequency, the velocity is equal to f into lambda. Frequency into wavelength. And frequency is the source is here. So the given crystal frequency. So by the finding of this velocity, that is on the basis of finding the velocity, we can calculate various parameters like mu, refractive index. It is refractive index or something like the analysis of the materials or liquid wherever it is required. So this part is the experimental part that we have to carry out in our lab. So this is all about the